baas wil een van zijn werknemers belonen.
This is a guy that I admire so much.
Een jongeman met een bijzonder geheim.
And I find out he's been homeless.
Some days I won't eat. Some days I scrounge up some money somewhere to get something.
Als het team in zijn verleden gaat graven, wordt duidelijk hoeveel wilskracht hij heeft.
When I was 17, I had 2,000 miles. My parents can see who I am right now. I would love them to see this ambitious, responsible young man.
Maar nu staat zijn carrière op het spel.
We have to make him think he is fire.
Door een vreselijk ongeluk.
Oh, you want to stop?
Yes.
En een onverwachte reunie met zijn vader. Wordt hem allemaal te veel.
I think we have the mark of all marks. So this is a little different. This was a submission I'm bringing in. My friend Rick Caruso, one of the most successful businessmen in the country. He develops major real estate projects, shopping centers. In fact, he owns a lot of the properties that we shoot our mobs on. He called me and got me, you know, they said, I want to do a mob on one of my employees. This young man, a concierge at the Grove, who apparently is doing an amazing job. It turns out, this kid was homeless, two jobs he's holding. He's trying to raise money because he had to drop out of college. Rick wants to give him a raise and a promotion. Ashley, one of our producers, got the mark on tape under the guise of they're doing a special on the service industry. This is the guy, and I believe he's incredibly deserving, and I want to do something for him. Watch this.
Hi, my name is Anthony Henry. I have two jobs here at the Grove. I work for a concierge, and I also work as a sales associate. I love making people's day. You know, my motto is, you know, I don't know how they were before they came up to me, but I want them to leave with a smile. And 4 years ago, I moved to California. It's been up and down, you know. Definitely I've seen more down than up.
Tell me about being homeless. What is that like?
Something. It was either stay here and struggle or move back to North Carolina. The day that I decided to move back, I called my dad. He didn't say anything. He hung up on me. It just made me think. I was like, you know what? He probably stopped believing in me because we've already had a history. You know, he kicked me out of the house when I was 17 and he never really understood me bash heads. Our logic's different from what they wanted me to do. So different from what I want to do for myself. Ever since then, it's just been like, I have to, you know, prove everyone wrong.
Would you be excited for your parents to see the man you've become?
That is what I think about every day.
Wow.
I love this guy.
The key here, it's all about his parents. Right. He wants to prove to his father.
Absolutely. I mean, you know, to be able to validate himself or prove himself in his father's eyes, I think is probably one of the biggest things that this story has going for.
Well, the key is that his father has to be here to witness this. That's the key to this whole thing. I think that I feel a special weight to make this beautiful, life-changing mob happen in front of his family. To be a success in front of the two people he respects in life would be amazing.
Good. Let's do it.
Gotta make the dream come true. And now the hard work begins. How to make this the most spectacular, the most moving, the most deserving mob we have ever done. Let's scout. So here we are. We're on this street. You know what would be great? What if the whole thing takes place just in the street?
Why don't we just make it like a street party?
But it's a great idea.
People dancing on cars.
Dancing in the street.
He stays right here.
Like that. A car would drive up and people would hop out and dance.
But we need some cool cars. How do we get some cool cars?
Like, how about lowriders?
Yeah. Lowriders would be amazing, like bumping.
That's a fun idea.
There's something like that.
I love it. We'll get some limos with a hot tub in the back. We can have some girls in the bikinis.
I like limos, hot tubs, girls in bikinis.
Hello, I'm here.
So this one is going to be different than all the rest. We're going to take the mark into the street, and the street is going to grow into this giant street party, which includes not only dancers, not only music, but vehicles.
Okay, let's move on.
This gives me an idea.
What is your idea?
In the left turn, we have to make him think, I mean, he's gonna get a raise and a promotion, so we have to make him think that he is fired. What could he be fired for? What if he ruins a car?
Why would that get him fined?
Well, what if it was his boss's car?
That would get him fined.
Now you're talking.
Okay, so here's what we do. We will ask him to deliver a car to his boss here, and then we'll ruin the car.
How?
We bring the car from down this street, under the chandelier, and we drop the chandelier on the car.
That would be awesome. You think they'll go for it?
No.
Can something fall off a balcony?
Something could fall off a balcony.
I just want to make sure I've got it straight. You want to pretend we've got Caruso's car.
Right.
Anthony, drive it to Caruso here.
Right.
And then destroy it?
Yeah. And make it seem like it's Anthony's fault. And then he has to face his boss and tell him, I've destroyed your car. How cool is that?
Did you say how cruel is that?
Yeah,
it's cruel and cool. So let's do that.
I'm really excited about the launch of this. We're starting with a stunt. We're gonna crash someone's car. It's dangerous and it's cool, and it definitely will get
a good reaction,
and he's gonna be so emotional about this. It's exactly where we want him.
The car will be someplace here and we'll destroy it. We'll figure out a place.
Hi.
How are ya? Can we drop a refrigerator off your balcony?
How about a piano?
Can we drop a piano off your balcony? Yes. Okay.
Let's go
up. Hi.
How are you?
Howie Mandel.
I know. What's everything you doing?
Oh, well, thank you. I'm Howie. I do this.
Oh. Oh, yeah.
Well, yeah.
You remember that.
How are you doing?
Oh, this is...
So what were you saying about what were you going to throw outside?
We just want to drop things off the balcony. So what should we drop off?
Well, I'll drop off a watermelon again.
You want to drop a watermelon off?
Yeah.
The lovely Phil, he is so into our show that he's willing to take his own produce and throw it over the balcony. We'll make sure nobody's there, and you toss it out a little bit so it'll run. This will be great. Ready? We okay? And the guy in the blue shirt. Okay? One, two, three.
Look out below.
Now we're gonna do the couch. I think we got the desired effect. It would be better had there been a car there. But no, just a practice session. But we got a plan. We're gonna smash a car, we're gonna do a street party. If all works out, Anthony is going to have the relationship that he wants with his father. It's gonna be spectacular, and it's not like anything we've ever done before.
It's the morning of Mom, and this is scene one behind us. Actually, it's scene one, scene two, and every scene. We're in one location. Starts small, and then it gets bigger, and then out of nowhere, more people show up. I'm excited for that because it'll feel a little bit different. We're not on the move. Okay, great, because we have a lot to do. All right, here we go.
This is a man's mob.
Let me try one more sandbag kind of lined up right here. You ready?
There's more danger involved in this particular mob because we're doing a stunt. We're going to be dropping 250 pounds of metal onto a car.
My name's Matt Ketcher. I'm the stunt coordinator. And today, my job's to ruin a car. We're going to try a couple hundred pounds of chain.
Because I think one of your mandates was loud. You said loud.
Wait a second. There's no way that's a couple of hundred pounds of chain in a plastic bucket.
Yeah.
It is.
There you go. You got it. So what? That is the cause of this.
I thought he was kidding.
When these buckets come out of the sky, they're going to be falling at a pretty high rate of speed. I think Anthony's going to completely freak out when that chain hits the car.
Can we add to this? Can we?
Yeah, absolutely. Two's good, three's bad.
It's going to be loud.
It's going to be loud.
There's a lot of testosterone on this set. We have all these cool stunts. We're crashing a car. We got low riders bumping in. Anything that's like macho-ness is here.
5, 6, 7, 8. Boom,
boom, boom, boom. Those are crazy.
Dancing cars.
You wouldn't think in the show Mob you would have cars and destruction and stunts.
You know what? I think I dropped a quarter under here. Let me get it.
Nope.
So Rick Caruso's arrived, and I'm going to walk him through everything we're going to be doing this evening when Anthony gets in.
Okay.
I'll take you through here. The ruse begins with Anthony driving the car into position. When he exits the vehicle, we're going to smash it. We'll then have our actor, Vic, who's playing the valet, bring Anthony round to meet Rick Caruso and explain what's happened. And you can have a bit of fun with him. Eventually, you should say, just show him.
Right.
Okay.
Okay.
I'm a little nervous for myself and for Anthony. I'm a little bit worried he's going to take it too seriously.
There'll be a big sea of people back here, and Anthony will be facing this way.
The mob will pop, his parents will be revealed at the back.
Wow.
He should get very emotional, because truthfully, he wants the recognition of his father's eyes.
Right.
And to do this in front of his parents, and to be recognizing the quality of this individual, it should blow him away.
I know that Anthony really wants to show his parents that he's made it on his own. So that moment when his parents get revealed, I think is going to be, well, it's going to be a special moment.
Jabberwockies performing as guest artists in this performance. It's just one of those things where all the stars aligned. They are Anthony's favorite act, and they agreed to show up for him. Honestly, they're a dance cult phenomenon. Anthony is gonna die when he sees them break out and perform. It's
gonna be crazy. Okay, so I hear that Anthony's parents are here. It's gonna be exciting.
Hello? Are you Anthony's parents?
Yes.
I'm Howie Mandel. Nice to meet you. And you are Donna and...
Lugar.
And Lugar.
Thank you for inviting me.
Tell me what you're thinking.
Excited. Nervous.
There's a few things going through my mind right now.
Come see what we've set up. And what we've set up is all for Anthony. Wow. Yeah. You look down the street.
My God.
All that. Oh.
Years.
Wow. You ain't seen nothing yet. There's 1,000 or 2,000 people here, all for Anthony. He has no idea.
4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2. Thank you so much, H. Just so much more to think.
Thank you so much for bringing Anthony into this world. I mean, he is a wonderful guy that deserves all this. Anthony's life is about to change forever. Rick Caruso is going to give him a raise, a promotion. He's going to change his future. But the biggest surprise of all, he's finally going to be able to show his parents the man he's become. To come down, we're getting our last minute rehearsals. The mob is lining up. So many things are going on at one time. So little time, so many boxes. feel like I'm in the Brady Bunch. Anthony is with our producer, Ashley, back at the Grove. He thinks he's doing a documentary, and then he's going to be sent on his way here to deliver what he thinks is Rick Caruso's car. He has no idea that he is about to get mobbed.
My name tag on, I guess.
Oh, there he is.
I like that answer.
Matt, you have a tight, you have a, I want closer.
All right, let's go. So start off by telling me the best part about your job.
The best part of my job is,
Can you cue Alexis in, please?
Empowerment.
Hey, I'm so sorry to charge you like this right now. I'm so sorry. I just got an urgent request from Rick, so unfortunately it's going to take precedence over this.
I'm so
Rick
nervous.
Rick has a huge surprise planned for his wife. He actually found her original car. It's like ridiculous sentimental value, so I need you to drive the car over there. We got it going because it's Rick and he comes first. We gotta go.
Okay, so we'll just go ahead and kind of pack up and then if it's possible.
Sure.
Yeah.
Here we go.
It's go time. Anthony has to drive the car from Rick's office to the Americana at Brand. There's so many things that can go wrong. The car breaks down, he gets a speeding ticket, and if that car doesn't make it, we're in trouble because we have no Mark, and then essentially we have no mom.
So scared to drive this car.
Ready to go? You're gonna call him in now.
Here we go. Ask him how far away it is. Hello? Hey, how you doing? Rick?
Are you on your way?
Yes, I am. I'm heading down Santa Monica Boulevard right now.
I want you to pull, you know where Valley Parking is on Caruso?
If you come up Ram and then just pull into Caruso, and then park there at Valet, okay?
Okay.
Thank you so much for doing this. I really, really appreciate it. You saved me tonight.
No problem. No problem.
You're probably driving.
Be careful, because you don't want anything to happen to the car.
Yeah, I am so scared and nervous.
Don't be too scared. Just relax. Everything's fine. Just relax. You got this far. Nothing can go wrong. Just chill. Don't worry about it. You're fine. You're good.
Okay, wait, we're gonna get set. Thank you, everybody. He said he's scared to death.
Everybody, we're 2 minutes away. This is real. 2 minutes away, last announcement.
He's on his way. Lights ready?
Okay,
music ready?
Okay, ready for the
car
coming.
Video ready? Car's coming in. Roll camera. Here it comes. Here it comes. Good, good. Right up to the red. Right up to the red. And...
we should toggle the driver. We should toggle the driver right now. We should toggle the driver.
This guy.
Oh, that's great.
Are you Anthony?
Yes, I am.
Oh, you need to see Vic in the garage.
Okay. So, I leave the car right here?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. I just left right here, right?
Yeah, I just leave it right here. He's inside the garage.
Tina, if we can change the sign, Tina. I have your position on here. Back to your main position. He's in position.
Okay.
He's in position.
Okay.
In position.
Okay. All right, ready? Bring him out. Bring him out.
Okay, we're bringing him out. Stop it.
Just show me where is the car. Okay, is it right? This is the car?
Yeah.
Come here.
Let's
see. So, hold on. This car right here?
Yeah.
Okay, my problem. Yeah, there's no parking here.
3, 2, 1, do it.
Watch out!
I told you not to park here. I told you that you can't have people willy nilly.
Why you didn't want me to move the car?
I wanted you to move the car. We were coming out
of
here.
Well, you told me not to move.
Why did you leave the car there?
They are there.
Who told you to park here?
Oh. It was just a gentleman right here.
Just a gentleman.
It says no valet parking. Look at the sign.
It even says no valet parking. The sign. What does it say?
You see this?
That's why the cones are there. I told you not to park here.
Really?
The cones are there so nobody parks there. Yeah, there's no parking here.
Let's go tell Rick. You go tell Rick.
This is, wait a minute, this is Caruso's car. So, you know what, you're going to have to give the keys to Mr.
Give the keys?
Yeah.
You told me to walk in there and meet and lift.
Sir, I'm not here to argue with you.
I'm not going to go in there if this car's messed up.
Oh my God.
Park the car.
He's twisting.
I took so long to get here.
Come on. I'll show you where he is. I don't know why you parked that. Okay, Mr. Caruso's up there.
Hey, Anthony.
This is what happened.
Hey, doing, buddy?
Rick, how you doing?
Hey, thanks.
Come in for a second.
Hey, guys, I'll catch up with you. Yeah, all right, thanks.
Hey, have a seat.
Shh, here we go.
Hey, thank you so much for bringing the car out, you know.
I have been looking for that car for 5 years. Believe it or not, this is a car that I gave my wife when we first got married. It took me 5 years to find that car.
That one?
That one.
That's it.
Because she hasn't seen it in about 20 years. So tonight she's here. She's doing a little shopping. I sort of sent her off. And then now I'm going to take her around there and surprise her and just say, can you believe we found this car? Because she was so in love with it. It's just going to be an awesome night. How did it drive?
It drove well. It drove well.
Yeah, thank you so much. I mean, I knew that you would just reject it, you know, get it out of here. Now we're all
going to go.
I'm so excited about it. Are you excited? You know, that because you could be like in the distance and see when she sees it. It's going to be a blast.
That's going to be,
it's over.
Man.
I don't know, you look disturbed. Anthony.
I can't even look at you and tell you. I'm stuttering. Alright? I'm stuttering.
You can't even talk.
I parked the car.
Okay.
And a big chain fell on the car and destroyed the whole.
You're not talking about my wife's car.
Yeah,
Where did the chain come from?
I can't talk because I'm so nervous right now.
Okay, let's go look at it. Show me.
You know what? I gotta see what you're talking about.
Whatever.
Yeah. Come on.
Can we just? I don't think it's a good idea for me to do this.
He doesn't think it's a good idea. Where to take him?
I listened to the director. I listened to everything he told me. I parked the car, and they told me to go inside and talk to Vic, and then a big chain fell.
Here they come, Vic.
Hey, Vic told me. Hey, Vic told me. Vic, okay.
Oh my God.
Vic, the guy told me to park right here.
Okay, listen, Anthony, it doesn't matter. I mean, what would you do if you were me? I mean, seriously.
He's going to go. He's getting ready. You're ready. Get ready.
I'm sorry, Anthony, but I think I got to reevaluate. You know, your position with the company, your being with the company. I mean, my God, look at this car.
Cue them in.
Cue the low riders. You'll have one shot. This doesn't make any sense to me. Oh, no, wait.
Just make a
his car, bro?
Hey, bro, man, don't talk to me like this right now.
You wrecked his car, bro?
Yes.
Don't worry. Hey, about a thing.
Here we go. Let's do
it. Shoot the drop. Shoot the drop.
So taken with how hard you work and your determination and your strength and what you mean to this company, I wanted to celebrate that not just with a few people, but I wanted to celebrate it with hundreds of people. That's why we did this. But there's two people that are extra special to you, and I want you to turn around. Terrific man, a terrific employee. But there's two people that are extra special to you, and I know how special they are, and I want you to turn around.
was his parents to see how good he was doing. This is so, oh my God.
Nice. Now, I know you know this, but you raised a remarkable son, and you should be so proud tonight. I know the apple never falls far from the tree. It's great, and you know, whatever you did, he's such a compassionate, loving, caring human being that just represents our company so well, and he has a fire in him that's incredible. He's on fire.
Yes.
Anthony? You were on fire.
Thank you.
Sir Anthony, what do you think? Well, we know one thing. You're not driving another one of my cars. Hey, I have had literally thousands of employees in my career. I've only met a few people like yourself, and I mean that. I think you are the future. I think you're the future of this company. Let me tell you how we're going to get that started, if you don't mind, because I want you to have a full-time job with us, not a part-time job, okay? Does that work for you? And you're getting a full-time job not because you need it, it's because you earned it. And the second thing is, with a full-time job and because of how well you've done your job, I want to give you a promotion. I know it's important to you. I know when, before you got into, you know, some financial trouble and whatnot, you became homeless, you were going to Art Institute of California, and you wanted to be in, I think, the music side of the business, right? And my spies told me you got about 85 units, and then you had to drop out. You couldn't afford it anymore, had to start working. It also is important that you have the future that you dream of. So, we're going to give you a scholarship so you can finish that school. There, I'll share it with you. Me crying. You got anything to say? Take your time.
Excuse me. All I wanted to do in my life was to succeed and be the best person that I could possibly be. Not only for myself, but for my parents. I want to thank them, you know, for allowing me to struggle at times, you know. It makes you who you are.
He said and more. And we here at MOG, with the help of all these people, and mostly Rick, wanted to change somebody's life. When you came in today, you were trying to deliver a car, which we broke. Okay, and you leave with a raise, with a promotion, and a scholarship that goes toward your future. So what do you say we have a party? You ready to go?
Yes, I am.
Okay, let's go. Thank you, MOG.
Tonight really my hope. For sure. 150 million percent. I can't even tell you the last time I saw my parents.
Whatever you did, he's such a compassionate, loving, caring human being. That just represents our company.
They finally know. Everything that I've been trying to show them for years, they saw it right in front of their eyes.
I have had thousands of employees in my career. I think you are the future.
And to hear that from Rick, who everybody looks up to, you know,
Thank you.